So welcome back everyone. So with the spirit that the show must go on, we must just welcome our next speaker for our technical session 7, day 3. So we welcome our distinguished keynote speaker for this session, Dr. Dilip Kumar, Department of Pharmaceutical Chemistry, Pune College of Pharmacy, Bharati Vidyapeeth University, Pune, India. So we welcome you to the virtual platform of Kite Group of Institutions, Ghaziabad. So this session is chaired by Dr. Alankar Srivastava, Associate Professor, Department of Pharmaceutics, Kite School of Pharmacy, Ghaziabad. So now I request Dr. Alankar to please welcome Dr. Dilip Kumar sir by virtually presenting a bouquet of flowers. Surya sir.
Welcome sir.
Welcome, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Alankar sir. Thank you, organizing team.
So we welcome you, sir, here. So again, I request Dr. Alankar sir to please introduce Dr. Dilip Kumar sir to the participants. Alankar sir.
Yes. Thank you, Dr. Dipti. It's a great pleasure for me to introduce our keynote speaker of this session. I would like to request again all the participants to join me in welcoming our next speaker of this session, Dr. Dilip Kumar, as an eminent speaker. Dr. Dilip Kumar received his B.Pharm from Manipal College of Pharmaceutical Science, Manipal University, and M.Pharm from SGS-ITS Indore, Madhya Pradesh. During his research, he published many research and review articles in peer review journals. He was awarded Junior Research Fellowship by National Medicinal Plant Board, New Delhi, Senior Research Fellowship from University Grant Commission, UGC, Teaching Assistantship and Institute Postdoctoral Fellowship from IIT BHU, Varanasi. At present, he is teaching as an Assistant Professor at Pune College of Pharmacy, Bharati Vidyapeeth University, Pune. His current research interest includes the design and development of adamantyl analogs as GLU-N2B selective NMDA receptors antagonists and amyloid beta protein aggregation inhibitors for the treatment of Alzheimer's disease. He is presenting the topic adoption of virtual reality technologies for drug discovery, the centerpiece of academic and industry labs. Sir, on the behalf of KSOP and all participants, I heartily welcome you here, sir. Sir.
Thank you, Alankar.
So now
sir.
It is over to you, sir.
Yeah. Thank you very much, Vaisali ma'am, Dipti ma'am, and all the organizing team. I feel humbled to get in such an introduction from you. And it
Thank
is
you,
a
sir.
Pleasure that such activities being conducted by you for the welfare of the pharmaceutical society and the students. And so should I share my slide?
Yes, sir.
So today I am going to give a talk on collaborative approaches to implement virtual reality methods for healthcare. So by using virtual reality for healthcare, we have proposed that there is enhancement of and there is augmentation of so many things, and the beneficial thing in the development and design of not only the molecules and drugs, but the subsidiary or supplementary things that is useful in the healthcare. So let's begin with the introduction. There has been a recent dramatic augmentation in the ways in which we can deliver medical education, and this is not only been through the internet and mobile devices, but through immersive technology. This technology include augmented reality and virtual reality. They can transform, however, we deliver so many educational experiences that can be increased. And development of virtual reality during the past decade or the past century, developments in film, television, computers, internet, and multimedia have enhanced the power of images. So the evolution of virtual reality from 1838 to present year, this has taken place, and we can see the gradually it is being developed by the virtual interference environment workstation and the development of computer in silico drug designing and the recent software that has been developed by scientists across the globe. And it was developed based on contribution from this media. However, virtual reality is quite different from this technology due to it provides a sense of presence, and the presence means feeling of actually being within a virtual experience. So we are doing work in the real sense, but the feeling is in the virtual arena. And the experience of virtual reality is achieved through the real-time, fully interactive interface of an individual with a 3D imagery in real-time, and that was made possible by development of more powerful computers and graphic processors. As we can see that when we, in normal phenomena, when we want to type on the Google, earlier we used to type, now we can speak, and then there is the sound that is being processed and it is written on the screen. So the simple use of the artificial intelligence in converting the speech into the handwriting or typewriting is a simple example for using the artificial intelligence. So for using our health purpose, there are virtual gyms, both for human and for animals in US or in the developed country, where they use a virtual gym to strengthen the muscle, to strengthen the body, and to enhance the physical and mental capacity of human being. Virtual reality has been adopted across medical and nursing fields. It involves the user putting on a virtual reality headset to become completely immersed in an interactive virtual environment. And when used with appropriate educational software, this allows the user to learn from experience in virtual world. Extended reality is a term referring to all real and virtual combined environments and human-machine interactions generated by computer technology and wearables. Type of extended reality are, we can divide it into virtual reality, augmented reality, and mixed reality. And this can be again subdivided into. So for virtual reality, augmented reality, and mixed reality, where how to use all these algorithms, how to use all these into a amalgamation of both three, where virtual, augmented, and mixed reality can be helpful for generation of better health system, for generation of not only development and design of molecules, but coming to the common people, how this artificial intelligence or virtual reality can be helpful at low economical pace, at low economical rate. This is the topic, and this is the real scene in health scenario. Just like augmented reality, it overlays digital image onto your view of the real world, often through a smartphone. And virtual reality, it primarily uses a headset to create an immersive 3D experience. So coming to the point, what is virtual reality? Basically, it is a computer generated stimulation or simulation which allows experience that can be similar to or completely different from the real world. Application of virtual reality includes entertainment, education, business, and healthcare. Although entertainment, social connections, and gaming will drive the initial adoption of virtual reality technology, the deepest and most significant market for VR will be the clinical care and improving health and wellness of people, and in larger sense in the society. So basically, this is a revolutionary technology, and there have been numerous attempts in the 90s to produce a better virtual reality, smart glasses. All attempts failed due to inadequate immersion of users in the virtual world and the poor quality and performance of computer and displays. But later, when there was touch screen was developed and designed in Texas, it is now happening. It has become a real thing for real force. Head-mounted display was created by a young man named Palmer Luque, founder of Oculus in 12. And this technique enabled users to experience immersive gaming experience in front of a screen and have the feeling that they were part of the virtual world. So application of virtual reality in healthcare. First, we will see how it facilitates the medical trainers, relief tool for doctors, used for surgical intervention, and it is used as a therapy to relieve mental stress, because there are so many mental patients across the globe. When before the use of internet, or before the internet is and after the internet is, the mental patient and their systematic relief is much sought, and the adverse and there are so many drugs that is available, but they have certain adverse drug reaction or side effects. And treatment of phantom limb pain, these are the application in healthcare. So in medical benefit, the virtuality can be used as a medical as a benefit in medical field. It can reduce errors, it can reduce training cost, it can increase confidence, store patient data digitally. The data of the patient can be stored, just like we have the population Aadhaar card. Restoration of patient, it can improve safety of the patient, it can motivate and entertain the patient, improve communication, it can have increased accuracy and have decreased or diminished surgical time. So these are the added advantage or the benefit of virtual reality benefits in medical field. So how virtual reality is changing healthcare? First, it exposure therapy, relaxation for chronic, robotic surgery, health education in terms of recovery time, psychological changes, psychological motivation, psychological counseling, and growth analysis. Medical virtual reality application, visualization, that is the virtual endoscopy, bronchoscopy, colonoscopy, these all uses AI, computer assisted surgery like training, planning, rehearsal, delivery, radiotherapy planning, dentistry, rehabilitation and therapy, telemedicine, and latest education, that is teaching, training, defining level of skills. How is virtual reality used for healthcare? Like medical training, pain management, virtual reality for children, mental health and psychological therapy. And for the better use of and the better health of the teeth, collaborative approach. Nowadays, the state of art in virtual reality researcher includes the collaborative virtual reality environments for medical training and teaching. The use of such collaborative environments allow students to share their knowledge or to be assisted by a tutor during a simulation. And virtual environments are used clinically to treat several important medical and behavioral health problems like post-traumatic stress disorder, generalized anxiety disorder, social anxiety disorder, depression, autism spectrum disorders. So VR technology is now affordable, scalable, and accessible. Gone are the days when the healthcare system were very chaotic, not only in the developing country, but also in the poor country. We did not have a basic infrastructure of healthcare, but as we are developing in all the sectors, so we are using a lot of virtual reality platform for the benefit of the health, like Facebook, HTC Vive, Google Daydream, Microsoft HoloLens, and Sony PlayStations. Virtual reality in healthcare focuses on three main aspects. First is the surgical education and training. Second is medical and health prevention. Third is medical rehabilitation and psychological therapy. Surgical education and training, the experience of the surgery. A medical student can feel the experience of a surgery in a virtual medium by using the software, by using this platform, and this makes surgical intervention virtual and it will give the simulation and training risky intervention in virtual surgeries that will be much more have an added advantage to the budding doctors, and it can also plan surgery. Medical and health prevention, it can also help in the relaxation applications, sports, fitness and rehabilitation appliances, virtual flights and bike tours, virtual tour of the disabled, gambling elements or gamification are used for the motivation. In device experience with virtual reality, functionality of a medical device such as hearing aid, prosthetic or joint aids, in-body experience with virtual reality, understanding a mechanism of a drug, cellular function and organs of the human body. Medical rehabilitation and psychological therapy, exposure therapy in case of VRs, post-traumatic stress disorder or to overcome fears, this can be helpful. This can be used as an adjuvant. Pain therapy, the pain center of brain is distracted and the sensation of pain during the treatment is significantly reduced to the patient, rehabilitation of stroke patient, those who have undergone the brain stroke, nutritional counseling and exercise trainer in case of obesity and diabetes. Nowadays, due to the lifestyle diseases, this obesity and diabetes, it is a more common, and in coming 10 to 20 years, it is going to be the commonest form of a disease, and this can be helpful. This artificial intelligence and the use of virtual reality can be very helpful. Rehabilitation of stroke patients, nutritional counseling and exercise trainer in case of obesity and diabetes. Gaming apps for understanding and behavioral training of diabetes patients, reduction of the drug failure rate in children through virtual gaming concepts. Parkinson's simulation from a perspective of a patient, whether he has a different gait or not, and in terms of also Alzheimer patient who is having loss of memory. So this can be helpful in reminding or remembering the neuronal loss that a patient have undergone in the past. So product marketing, that is a term that is being used, how it can enhance the different medical, we can say sojourn, for treatment sojourn, like diabetic wear, product presentation at trade fair, both. It has been started by Novo Nordisk. Rheumatism, patient experience and product features, ABVI, dermatology, the fight through disease skin layer, biotech marketing, Cast Pharma, they have started their product marketing also for the virtual reality. So the look into the future, there are several reasons why these applications are still in their infancy for healthcare. So though we have tried to delve deep into the virtual reality, both in terms of the economical and the from aspect from the machine, but still we have a long way, long road to travel it. So there are definitely some hurdles, some hiccups for the successful application of this. The legal requirement, that like patient protection and the implacement of the data, so the data should not be leaked. So there must be some confident data or secure data system should be there. The complex ecosystem with patients, doctors, therapists, health insurance companies, authorities, clinics, and pharmaceutical companies. The fact that high performance virtual reality glasses are still quite expensive for the end consumer, and the cost that is involved in it. So a lot of patients cannot afford it. The future of virtual reality in healthcare, a lot of virtual reality applications are still in their infancy. So a lot of the devices have so many lacuna, and they cannot be give 100% accuracy. And in the coming year, virtual reality will be used more and more, just like now nobody is going to bank for withdrawing the money. Everyone is using ATM. But 20 years back, we used to go to the bank and in the queue for taking money. So in the coming 10 to 20 years, the use of virtual reality will be just like a common thing, like ATM in the healthcare system. And this will improve the accuracy and effectiveness of current medical procedures and treatments, and it will also augment the capacity of human being, both as a caregiver or as a doctor or as a patient. And it will also give an enhance to train the doctors or for the medical trainers. This has the ability to transport you inside the human body. So what is happening inside the chamber of the heart from the virtual really use of this software, or using this, we can see, or a doctor who is aspiring to be a MBBS pass out, he can first see or visualize. After that, he can go to the cadaver. Currently, medical students learn on cadavers, which are difficult to get hold of and don't react in the same way as the live patient would do. So by using it, if a medical patient can feel the cadaver is responding just like a live patient, so he can have an added benefit in learning this thing, or the minor or the subtle demarcation of a live or dead patient or a bedridden patient. So in virtual reality, however, we can view minute details of any part of the body in a stunning 360 degree CGI reconstruction, and create training scenario that can replicate common surgical procedure. For surgery also, we have a a common platform or a common replication or the common replica of the body that can be used for simulation, and that will be helpful in giving the training for the body doctors. Medical Realities is one of the companies pioneering the use of virtual reality to deliver high quality surgical training. They film real life surgery in 4K 360 degree video from multiple angles that is then combined with CGI models of the anatomy that is being operated on to provide an immersive and interactive training experience. And for treatment, the patient education, the patient can also be educated, not only the doctors or the pharmacist, but patient can also be educated. The ability to view inside the human body in virtual reality is not only useful to doctor, but also for patient. And we can extend it to pharmacist also, that what is happening to the drug, to the patient, or what is happening to the effect of the drug to the patient. It can also be taught to the pharmacist. So when they are going to the hospital, or they are going on the duty, they previously during their clinical training or during their clinical pharmacy training or the 1 year course or in the classroom, or I think that will be also after 10 or 15 years, it will be also, we can do it in our lab, just like we are doing synthesis and other pharmacognosy and pharmaceutics practical. They can learn that what is happening when a drug is subjected to the patient, and for certain drug, what is happening if it is acting on the CNS, what type of activity, what type of adverse drug reaction, what type of lacunae, what type of shortcoming it will give. So that will give better perspective for the pharmacist. So when he will recommend the drug to the patient, he will be much more careful and much more cautious. So VR allows patient to take through their surgical plan by virtually stepping into a patient-specific 360 degree VR reconstruction of their anatomy and pathology, and the result enhanced understanding of the treatment and consequently higher patient satisfaction. So, and robotic surgery is a recent invention in which surgery is performed using a robotic device where a robot is used to do the surgery, just like for the appendix and for retina, and robotic arm that is controlled by a human surgeon who controls the robotic arm to use it to give the instruction how this can be not gone wrong, and it should not be in the wrong way. So there is always a human intervention or human supremacy, but the work done by robot, it is to facilitate the human efforts and to maximize the efficacy and accuracy. So this means fewer risk of complication during surgery and a faster procedure. So the robotic device, accurate meaning a smaller incision, reduced blood loss, or faster recovery. So the robotic arm will have much more precision and accuracy in contrast to the human doctors or their human counterpart. So it will be an added advantage to the patient. Mental health. Virtual reality has a unique ability to transport you somewhere else, can be used to create powerful simulation of the scenario in which the psychological difficulties occur. There are certain people, and I think 1 out of 10 people is suffering from the mental health in some or different manners. So virtual reality can allow them to travel in another world, so they can have a relief of their pain or suffering for some time or for some being. So virtual reality has been used to curb memory loss, help autistic children in the classroom, and gather data from dementia research that will be useful for the Alzheimer's research and Parkinson. Pain management and physical therapy, it also helps in, and it has the robust healing capabilities, and that are not just limited to psychological issue. They have been proved to work for pain management and physical treatment too. VR for physical therapy has also been shown to be effective in speeding up recovery time. So virtual reality has not only been to the mental, but for the physical therapy, this has also been very useful, and this can be used for removing the pain or to diminish the pain management by the physiotherapy also. So from the doctor to patient, to pharmacist, to physiotherapy, everywhere this virtual reality will play its pivotal role in curing or alleviating the suffering of the humankind in the near future. And also, and this has started for the last 10 years, the role of virtual reality in alleviating the suffering and pain of the humanity has started, and in future it will grow by leaps and bounds, and it will reach its zenith in the coming year, like normal we took in allopathy or homeopathy or any type of medicine. Their ultimate aim is to relieve or alleviate the suffering of humankind. So virtual reality is not a panacea for everything, but it has the end result that it will alleviate the suffering. But the suffering are such a thing that it has to be maintained, and it has to be introspected from the lot of things, like socioeconomic factor, the psychological factor, and the other mental health issue that a patient is undergoing or facing. So combining this, the virtual reality will help in the pain management and physical therapy in addition to the mental welfare of the patient. So this is the virtual reality for pain management. We can see a child who is suffering from some disease like autism or any other can have see this camera and can divert his mind or her mind for some time, and the pain that he or she is suffering will be subsidized by using it. So it allows the patient to do their prescribed daily exercise in a virtual environment, and that makes the activity more fun, keeps the patient focused, and helps them keep their spirit up during what can be a long recovery period or long recovery time. So with the help of this, the patient can have a much more better environment rather than the previous which was used. And another is the disease awareness. Pharmaceutical Research and Development Company, AbbVie, created an experience to raise awareness among healthcare professionals of the daily struggle of patients suffering from Parkinson's disease. Some pharmaceutical company have also started working on it, that how the awareness about the disease can be raised, and there must be an awareness about the certain type of disease, especially for the CNS, for Parkinson and Alzheimer. And the experience was demoted at the pharmacy. It was showed demonstrated at the pharmaceutical industry trade, and it showed that where people could put on headset and experience firsthand as Parkinson sufferer navigate a virtual supermarket, encountering awkward moment when coming into contact with other people. So it in virtual mode, it is showing that when a patient who is suffering from Parkinson, when he is encountering so many people, or in a virtual medium, he is going to buy something from the supermarket, what will be his response, and what will be his feeling. So such type of a demo in the trade fair or will help the patient or the elderly patient who is suffering from Parkinson or Alzheimer to reduce their symptom, to have their more confidence, to have their robust awareness about this, and this will also help them in their curbing the disease or lowering the death rate. So virtual reality in medicine and pharmacy, medical progress is happening in front of our eyes. In the last decade, we have seen how the there is a progression in medical from the electronic also, and everywhere the science is leaping bound, and science is doing its progress. So medical and pharmaceutical field is also not left behind. It is also the part and parcel of the scientific arena where all these things happens. So complex virtual reality simulation helps the doctor learn, and they also support the rehabilitation of patients. And virtual reality and that augmented reality allows researcher to catalog and visualize all their data. And all these data, these are categorized by the researcher. They visualize it, they catalog it, and they find the inference about this, what will happen and how this can be minimized. So with the help of virtual reality, they can improve the efficiency of pre-developed phases of a particular drug. Virtual reality enables them to visualize the interaction between molecules better, and thus re-engineer and design the molecules. Virtual reality has been used for the drug designing, and role of artificial intelligence in designing molecules for targeting a selective receptor. Let's suppose if you are taking the example of matrix metalloproteinase receptor for curbing Alzheimer's disease, the role of MMP2, matrix metalloproteinase 2 and 9, that there are so many MMPs. So how we can design a molecule based on their based on the interaction of the molecule or the desired, better say, lead candidate on the different pocket, like we have S1, S2, S3, S4, S5 pocket in the MMP. How these molecules fit best in their S5 pocket, we can use it. And then we can design better molecule that will bind to the MMP and alleviate the cancer or Alzheimer that is being governed by this enzyme. In the same way, other enzyme or the receptor can also be a suitable example. So virtual reality is perfect for studying human anatomy on real life models. We can also study the human anatomy by using this. It provides incomparably more than just accurate anatomical models of human body. Earlier, when we were in the pharmacy in first year in Manipal, I have seen that our batchmate used to, those who were in the medical field, MBBS first year, they used to study Netler Atlas. That was a Atlas book by Netler and a British scientist who had the diagram of all the bones and the anatomy of the human. But if we are using the virtual reality, people can visualize all this on their laptop or their platform. This how this bone will look from the 3D view without having the gone to the lab, and they can remember all the intricacies of the bone or the small bones, long bones, where ulna, femur is there, and their subanatomy or the sub part that will be helpful in remembering the bone and their uses. So the virtual reality is not only helping for the medication or the designing of drugs, but for the smallest thing like the remembrance of the bone in the anatomy class, it boosts the performance of the student or the medical student. And when performing a variety of treatment or surgery, doctors got information on how the patient body reacts and what should be the suitable thing, what should be the intricate and complex situation that can be created with the participation of numerous experts in their fields. And most of the simulators are used in university hospitals. Some of them have already been allocated to a commercial place. Benefits of virtual reality. So 99% realistic 3D environment it prepares, or it gives realistic simulation in various places. It has amazing possibilities for both laboratories and operating rooms. 52% medical skill improvement. Training in VR technology is more effective. Students learn faster and remember better when this technology is utilized and data has been collected, that the memory of a student or the learner, what they feel about this. 47% saving, that is the virtual reality training can be used multiple times with a constant level of effectiveness. There is no diminished effectiveness because this is done by the robotic media or by artificial intelligence software. So there is no, just like any Titani phase, or there is no S phase. So the graph is always increasing. So what are the benefits of virtual reality for medicine? Its application are designed precisely to let the trainee make mistakes while training. So good training increases trainee professional competence. There are some exercises that are especially designed where a budding medical profession will do the wrong, and what and how this can be cured, how this can be rectified. And the chronic patients often experience the discomfort of being partially left to their own devices in between the procedures. VR and AR can make their experience a little bit less uncomfortable and probably more exciting. 3D anatomical models belong to the earlier innovation with VR and AR that help students learn about human body in depth. Most VR applications fall under the realm of education and improving the competence of future doctors and nurses, but this technology can also be used in their daily work. A key aspect of VR technology is its reliability. We can have 100% faith on its system and rehabilitation. using VR technology is more pleasant for a patient, and the latest applications are extremely immersive and motivating. And among other important implementation, this is currently used in the treatment of such diseases as vision defects, anxiety and phobias, and in broadly understood rehabilitation process. Next is virtual reality for mind. The VR applications allows to reduce stress, anxiety, and improve human well-being. It has been observed by the data scientists that when the VR application has been utilized, it has been helpful in reducing the stress, anxiety that most of the people nowadays are suffering, and particularly for the last 2 years when the use of the screen has much more increased for the child or for the teachers or for everywhere working professional. So how this virtual reality can be utilized to de-stress the mind of the worker or the people who are using it? So neuroscientists have found that regular meditation has beneficial effect on changes in the brain regarding concentration and self-control. So in addition to the regular meditation, like the subsidiary health system we have, yoga and other things, or vipassana, this can also be utilized to relieve the stress in the different countries.
सर आपका वॉइस ड्रॉप हो रहा है अलंकार सर
यस मैडम
आपको आवाज आ रही है
नहीं नहीं आ रही है
ओके कैन यू हियर मी मैम
यस सर
नाउ इट इज ऑडिबल
ओके सर देयर माइट बी सम इंटरनेट ग्लिच ड्यू टू दिस जस्ट I am sharing it again. So, can you see the PPT? Is PPT visible?
It is visible, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay, it is there. Okay. Virtual reality for mind.
Yeah, virtual reality for mind. So, in addition to the different subsidiary system that a different country or different geographical region, people or humans from different races have been applying, like yoga in India, Zen in the China and Japan. So the use of virtual reality, it is finding much more utility in reducing the stress, anxiety, and other things that is related to the CNS disorder and the lifestyle of the people or the worker across the globe. And I hope the future of the virtual reality will be there for de-stressing the minds. Virtual reality for stroke rehabilitation. Virtual reality stroke patient can practice their daily activities through gamification. The more active they are, the better it is for their health. So patients can play at home, and a physical therapist can plan activities and check results online. For a stroke patient, those who cannot move from their bed, it has been an added advantage to use this and to have their added benefit in their health care or the betterment of their health. So definitely, when we are using any system, there are some pros, there are some cons. We have seen the pros till now, that it break up the monotony and gamifies your routine, connects you with other people, it reduces self-consciousness. But the cons are, it is expensive, it is not affordable to all the people, and when the health is not affordable to all the people, when it is not for all the people, particularly in the developing countries or in the southern Asian continent, in our peninsular region, people, those who are working for their bread, they cannot afford such hi-fi facility at this level for their health checkup when they don't have the money for their own livelihood. So we must be careful, or we must design such a system that it should be very less expensive, like earlier days when the cost of telephone or the mobile was very much more than 16 rupees, I think, for incoming in 1970-98. But nowadays, it is almost free. So in the coming days or in the coming years, we have to devise such a system, such a software that will be useful. And the people who is living in the remote village of the India, can use it or can utilize it for its betterment of health care, or in every you can say the प्राथमिक उपचार केंद्र जब वर्चुअल रियलिटी का जो साधन है या जो संसाधन है हर जगह उपलब्ध हो तभी यह समझा जाए कि यह पूरे भारतवर्ष में इसकी उपयोगिता का उपादान हुआ है. एंड अनदर थिंग दैट देर आर सो मेनी कंप्यूटिंग पावर्स, देर आर सो मेनी कंपनी दोज हु आर डूइंग रिसर्च ऑन इट, दे वांट टू मोनिपलाइज इट, दे वांट टू हैव देयर ओन सिस्टम, दे डोंट वांट टू गिव इट. सो देर मस्ट बी a legal battle, or there must be, we have to frame the legal rules by the different government or the different Supreme Court of country, respective country, so that it can be availed by the masses or the commonest of the common people. When they can use it, then the real purpose of the virtual reality for to healthcare will be utilized, and that will be the real success of the virtual reality. And not only this, any medical thing, any medical devices or advancement that is designed or developed, unless and until it doesn't reach the common people of the any country, it is useless, it is futile. And another thing, that it requires some open space. We have some good infrastructure to keep all these instrument. So from the basis of infrastructure level, we have to develop it, our own infrastructure where it can be kept, or the health worker or the worker who is, or the skilled worker better say, who is monitoring it, should have a greater infrastructure to monitor it or to regulate it. They must be also provided some platform. So these are the pros and cons of the virtual reality, and it must be looked and it must be introspected by the respective government, so it will be reality for the common masses in the coming days or in the coming years. So virtual reality in pharmacy, coming to our field where we are seeing, where we are working. So in pharmacy, virtual reality can be potentially applied as follows: adjunct or a replacement for pharmacotherapy in drug design and discovery, in pharmacist education, in patient counseling and behavior modification. We know that pharmacists are the bridges between a doctor and a patient. So the role of pharmacist is very, very important in combining the compliances of the the patient and what the outcome that is coming from the doctor to the patient. And most of the patient in our country or any developing country, they don't understand the jargon of the scientific words or the doctors or physicians. They have their own local dialect or language. So a pharmacist should have a bridge between this doctor and a patient. He should communicate that how this drug can be utilized and what will be the side effect and how much time it can be taken. And not only this, how this can be used for a better pharmacotherapy to the patient and for the education of a pharmacist. So in coming year, I hope that this subject will be in the syllabus, that how this can be taught in our syllabus. So a pharmacist will learn and he will or she will utilize it to the patient, so to fill the gap between this doctor-patient miscommunication. First is the replacement treatment for pharmacotherapy in pain management. Research has demonstrated that virtual reality is effective for the treatment of pain associated with a variety of physical and psychological illness. So we have seen till now that the virtual reality is very much effective in decreasing the different physical or psychological pain. So this can be utilized for the pain management, and this can be given by a pharmacist to the patient. It has been also observed that effective for acute or chronic pain caused by injuries, cancer, diabetic neuropathy, migraine, headaches, and pruritus, as well as many other conditions. So VR has also been found to be effective in treating pain associated with medical or surgical procedure like wound dress changes, intravenous line placement, or dental work. A controlled trial comparing VR with other distraction technique found that in children undergoing burn treatment, VR was more effective in reducing subjective pain severity than interacting with a child care worker or listening to music. So in a review of 7 studies, 5 demonstrated that VR is an effective non-pharmacological adjunct to a standard opioid analgesic treatment. So its utility and its beneficial effect has been recorded by data scientists in the patient who were having the opioid analgesic treatments, and it has been found that it is very effective for the patient. And in those studies, VR was found to reduce pain, de-stress, and anxiety in adult or a pediatric patient who were undergoing unpleasant medical procedures. Another randomized trial compared analgesia administered with and without a VR game. This trial demonstrated that VR combined with analgesic was significantly more effective in reducing pain in children undergoing burn treatment than were analgesic alone. So along with analgesic, when the VR game was given to the patient, especially to the children or pediatric patient, it was found that they had the better treatment efficacy, and the treatment regime was very much beneficial and helpful to the pediatric patient, and it also de-stressed the adult patient. So adjunctive or replacement treatment for pharmacotherapy in anxiety other disorder has also been recorded, and it exposure therapy has been applied in the treatment of post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD, generalized anxiety disorder, society anxiety disorder, panic disorder, obsessive compulsive disorder, agoraphobia, ergonophobia, claustrophobia. How the virtual reality therapy, how it can have in the different, it can help in the sleep disorder, stage fright, fear of public speaking. Some students, they fear that they cannot perform on the stage, and fear of a spider. Some have the fear of a spider or lizards. Some have the fear of the claustrophobia in the lift. They fear from the closed space or door. So, and some have eating disorder. So we can find that virtual reality therapy is everywhere, from stage fright to fear of heights and fear of driving. So by use of this virtual reality therapy, a patient or a child can feel that he is being subjected to certain condition, and finally he doesn't have to feel the pain or the fear that has been gripping him since his childhood or since many years. So this will be helpful in the treating it. Another example is virtual reality therapy for iconophobia, where a patient have a fear with the spiders. It is also the fear of height. Some people have the fear of height. It can be reduced. And pharmacological modeling of drug discovery, VR offers a number of advantages compared to other computer-based approaches used in drug design. Nowadays, we are using molecular docking and dynamic, but the virtual reality, which uses the artificial intelligence, is one step more forward in designing the molecules or designing the drugs and targeting their structure and targets. In drug discovery and design, visualization tools serve an important role with respect to the investigation of interaction between ligands and which are the potential drugs and macromolecules. So artificial intelligence and virtuality is proving a much more better pedestal to fight what were the lacunae that were in the molecular docking or in silico study. And it has been found that it is much more superlative in terms of its efficacy in targeting the enzymatic target or a particular amino acid in binding pattern, and they are selecting the ligands or selecting the drug-like candidates from thousands or millions database. And VR may be useful to pharmacy students who prefer visual learning opportunity rather than reading textbook. In coming days, it may be a reality that people, that a student will much more lay on the virtual platform for reading their textbook or the lab manual. They can visualize how this is happening in the lab rather than doing it or reading it from the books. And it has the ability to simulate a real life experience through role playing that allows user to improve clinical and communication skills by learning from their mistakes when providing care to virtual patients. And doctors, they can wear virtual reality glasses for examination of virtual patients, and they can help the medicine or the prescription in much more better way. So we can say that the word telemedicine will be very shorter, or it will be much more annealed in terms of this virtual reality, and the real use of telemedicine will come into the picture when the virtual reality will also be combined, and this will add an advantage to the patients, their healthcare system. It allows pharmacy students to assess and interact with different VR scenario remotely, facilitating distance learning or training. A student can assess training opportunity in a 3D VR world where simulated ward rounds and patient meeting occurs, especially for the clinical pharmacy students when they are doing round in the hospital. They have a virtual tour where they can feel that what the patient want and what is the drug interaction, what is the ADR, and in that condition what can be given, and some hypothetical question may be asked, some hypothetical problems, some hypothetical patient that has the some problematic feature or some disorder, they can also be given. And in the virtual platform can also be used to assess the students via their examination or via the use of the patient, the virtual patient, that if a patient is suffering from such disease, which drug will prescribe, what are the ADR of that patient. So it will be much more easy to assess for the examiner also at the university level or for the higher education. This will be a fun, new and exciting experience for the students also, rather than using their textbook or other things. They can also be used in pharmacy practice to simulate work processes, consumer or staff behavior. These things can also be monitored, and these things can also be controlled by use of virtual reality. How virtual reality could change Alzheimer care? So risk detection as young as as the age of 18 can be used to detect though a patient can have Alzheimer at its later stage or not. According to a study, the scientists were able to accurately identify which subject held genetic marker for Alzheimer. Their genetic markers can be identified for this particular disease in a patient by use of virtual reality. This means that with the help of VR, a scientist can diagnose high-risk patient as young as 18-year-old, allowing their families to plan future Alzheimer care. So we can see the prospect of virtual reality for a patient who is 18-year-old and when he will develop Alzheimer at the age of 65 years. So at least more than 40 to 50 year advanced planning can be done for a patient who has 18 years, and this environment can help in the treatment of patients. VR has already made its way into Alzheimer treatment in a handful of trials by leading Alzheimer care professionals. One such trial performed in 14 used Microsoft Kinect technology to create peaceful scenes such as sunlit forest that Alzheimer sufferers were able to interact with. And there are other technology where virtual tours or the virtual medium can be used to detect that whether a patient will have the Alzheimer or not, or if an elderly patient who is suffering from Alzheimer, how he can be treated with the use of virtual reality. And the future of virtual reality and Alzheimer care, since virtual reality is still in its infancy, it is tough to predict exactly how much of an impact this technology will have on AD. But many people see a lot of potential of virtual reality therapeutic use as VR technology becomes more widespread, accessible and affordable. We may see VR play a much bigger role in the treatment of AD, and the patient can have much more benefit in it. And there are exciting possibility in the creation of virtual environments that remind Alzheimer patient of their childhoods. It may even be possible to create customized environment for individual patients, including music or detailed or particularly soothing. Virtual reality cancer patient. Extending to other diseases like cancer, virtual reality can be used to improve functioning in patients with cancer also. Virtual reality may improve pain, vision, functioning in patients with cancer. Virtual reality can be used to solve pain management, restore vision, and improve functionality in patients with cancer. Supportive care with virtual reality has been implemented in many large seniors care centers, but misperception about the technology is abound in the society. People still need to be taught that this technology can be there, helpful and supplementary. It will not be destructive for them. And creating a virtual reality tumor, detailed reference picture of a tumor is taken and wafer thin slices are cut from the tumor. The slices are deeply analyzed right down to the genetic information. The information is processed and the tumor is revealed in virtual reality. And last step, multiple users wearing 3D virtual reality headsets can step into the tumor, view and analyze it simultaneously, that they have the virtual tour of the slice of the tumor, and they can help the identify, or it can help in curing the disease state. So VR can create an alternative, less stressful environment and easy to use. User of VR wear a head mounted display with a close proximity screen that creates a sense of being transported into three-dimensional world. It has been shown to be safe and effective in reducing emotional distress of patients undergoing chemotherapy. And virtual reality program is effective for pain management in cancer treatment also, because due to the radiotherapy, patient is suffering from so many psychological disorder, psychological problem, and the pain associated with the treatment, it has been used to alleviate it. It has been used to relieve the suffering of the patient. In concluding remark, we can say the virtual reality is used in many areas of healthcare, and it has a variety of application, not only in Alzheimer's, in cancer, in pain management, and other disease. It includes medical training for both doctor in training and students, patient treatment, medical marketing, and educating people about a disease or medical condition or process can be utilized. And the role of virtual reality can be extended to much more disease state and to much more geographical area. So this I'm about to end. Any question?
Yes, dear participants, anybody would like to ask anything?
Can I, ma'am?
Yes, sir. Yes,
Ghosh,
sir.
First of all, thank you, sir, for this wonderful presentation. Sir, my humble question is, sir, if a particular person, suppose, becomes too much busy in this virtual reality, then will his mind be able to differentiate between, suppose, 20 or 30 years from now? We have seen that last 10 years, we have made so much technical progress, that in 10 years ago, whatever Nokia phone you are having, now we have a small, almost a supercomputer in our hand, like a mobile, Android mobiles. So 10 years down the line, so when this virtual technology will mature more, sir, will any person's mind be able to differentiate between a real world and the virtual world? And if his or her mind is totally devoted in the virtual world, then what will be his physical condition? Like today's children are also very busy in Android phones. So in virtual reality, sir, what will be the worst case scenario?
Yeah, thank you, sir, for asking such a poignant question. It is very relevant. बहुत ही समीचीन प्रश्न है आपका. आजकल के बच्चे जो स्मार्टफोन में बिजी हैं, और अर्लियर नॉट ओनली इवन इन आवर जनरेशन, 10 ईयर बैक वी यूज टू और 15 ईयर बैक वी यूज टू रिमेंबर लॉट ऑफ फोन नंबर, बट वी नाउ वी डोंट रिमेंबर इवन ए सिंगल फोन नंबर. So definitely, too much indulgence for anything is harmful. It is deleterious for the human health or for the human brain. So there must be some parental care from the parent or from the teacher or the guardian for the children, those who are indulging too much in it. And too much dependence on technology is also harmful, because we are doing it against the nature. But the balance of the two, the technology for only for health or for benefit and not beyond that, is mandatory, or the balance between two is really relevant and important. So those who will be doing the balance, they will benefit it. Those who will not be in the balance side, definitely they will have some lacunae or some problem. Is it clear, sir?
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So, sir, your session was really very knowledgeable, and I hope the participants would have really benefited a lot. So now I request Dr. Alankar, sir, to please give the concluding remarks for the session.
Thank you, madam. Thank you, sir. That was really a very informative session. And no doubt the ability to view the inside the human body in virtual reality is not only useful for doctors, but also for patients also. Sir has presented the topic collaborative approaches to implement virtual reality methods for healthcare. And sir started lecture with brief introduction about virtual reality, augmented reality, and virtual reality. Applications of the virtual reality in healthcare, various applications in medical fields, how it is changing healthcare system and how it is used for healthcare, different visual reality platforms and other different aspects. How it is useful in diseases like Alzheimer's disease and future of the virtual reality in healthcare like medical training, medical realities and treatment of patients, robotic surgery, mental health, pain management, physical therapy, disease awareness, and how it can be applicable in pharmaceutical research. Sir has also covered one more aspect, and that is the application of virtual reality in the teaching learning also. And that is a new thing that we know that in the COVID time, we are sitting here and we are doing the meeting in this online platform. The students are also learning in an online platform. So this virtual reality will be a future in the teaching learning also. Sir has covered that topic also. So in this way, the sir has covered almost all the aspect of the this topic. And no doubt, sir, you have presented your topic in a very fine manner. And that was really a very informative session for all. Thank you again, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. In nutshell, I will say that Sajjano ki sangati hi sadguno ki khan hai. The company of the good people is virtue of all. Thank you, Vaisali ma'am, Alankar sir, and all the management team and the students, those who are not in the picture also. And thank you, your group, KIT group, in the School of Pharmacy. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dilip sir, for giving us the picture that the virtual reality is not only for drug designing, it is just beyond that. You have explained the topic very well. Thank you so much. It was very informative session. Thank you for accepting our request. And Dipti ma'am, please do the felicitation.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. So now I request Dr. Alankar, sir, to please present the certificate of gratitude to our keynote speaker, Dr. Dilip Kumar, as a small token of remembrance of the event.
Sir, on the behalf of KIT School of Pharmacy, my colleagues, organizers, and the participants, please accept this certificate, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. I am humbled by your...
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you,
Dilip, sir. Thank you so much for your kind presence here and for sparing your valuable time. Thank you, sir. Welcome, sir. So for next session, which we'll be having at, which is scheduled to be at 2:30 p.m., you all are requested to please be ready with your laptops with the, and you have to install PY by RX, P, capital P, small y, capital R, small x. So this has been messaged in WhatsApp group of FDP participants. So you can just check out from there. Or if you are using your mobile phones, then please install VR180, capital V, capital R, 180 from Play Store. Okay. So now it's the time.
Next session will be a hands-on session.
Next session, ma'am, 2:30.
Session. So for that purpose, you have to make these necessary arrangements with you ready so that you can also have the experience of hands-on for some chem informatics and bioinformatic tools which are available for virtual reality or augmented reality. So kindly do that. Yes, ma'am, please proceed.
Okay. So I hope this is a time for lunch. So ladies and gentlemen, we all can break for a meal now and we'll resume at 2:30. So enjoy your lunch. Have a nice lunch. Thank you. See you at 2:30. Please join on time. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.